And coming up this weekend, The Mentalist returns for its second season, and changes in the CBI leave Jane out in the cold. That's Sunday at 9:30, but now it's Shortland Street.
Look, I'd love to spend the weekend with you, but I have to go to New Plymouth.
Why?
I just got a call. My grandmother's seriously ill.
When's he going down?
He's already there.
That was quick. I saw him at the chemist this morning.
See, the grandma's recovered, or is she dead, eh? Isn't Anthony with you?
No, he's still in your book.
You sure? His car's parked around the corner.
Could be.
Where are you anyway?
At my grand's, of course. Just back from the hospital.
Is that true?
Yeah.
A few people saw you around town today.
Must have a double, eh?
Must have.
Tanya, still there? Tans? Talk to me, please.
On me?
No.
What is going on, Ant?
You just have to trust me.
This is starting to freak me out.
I'm sorry. I really am. I love you.
Then come back and talk to me.
I can't. I'm sorry, but I can't see you right now.
Fine, then I don't want to see you either.
Oh, so I should have come home with you. Even Alice couldn't find anything worth chatting up. You know how low her standards are. Am I at home, right? What are you staring at?
Nothing.
What's wrong?
You were right about Ant. It was his car at Coltrane.
I knew it was. I have perfect night vision.
I had this weird feeling about his trip to New Plymouth. And he just rang me now, pretending that's where he was. But he wasn't. He was outside the house, watching me.
Watching you?
When I tried to confront him, he just drove off.
Are you sure it was him?
I rang him. He didn't even come up with a decent excuse.
Had he been drinking?
I don't know. He sounded really weird.
Is it him? I saw him out.
No, don't antagonize him.
He's really freaked you out, hasn't he?
Oh, God, he's not going to stop.
Oh, yes, he is.
Morning.
Morning. You want a coffee?
Yes, please. Have we got visitors?
No.
And who's dossing there?
I came in late last night and I didn't want to disturb Maya.
Ah.
Morning.
Hey.
Here you go.
Mucho grassi.
You'll be needing these.
Thank you.
I'm running late, so I'll see you guys later.
Have a good one. What's going on, Jay?
Nothing. Maya's just a bit hungover.
Yeah, and you guys are fighting about something.
No.
Oh, whatever.
It's just, I found out about the airline pitch today, so it's just causing a bit of tension between us.
What, so she doesn't want you to get it?
No, of course she does. It's nothing, really. It's just a silly little tiff.
Looks
Looks like you've taken my advice too seriously.
What?
Pardon.
Pardon?
Going out and having some fun. You look awful.
I feel it.
Well, if it's that bad, maybe you should be at home.
That's the last place I want to be.
Oh, dear. What happened?
Jay and I have had a huge fight. She's so angry at me.
Is it about work?
And that guy Dylan who's mentoring her.
You don't like him?
I don't like the way that everything's about pleasing him. She doesn't see what her work obsession's doing to us.
I know it's hard, but it's a very important time for Jay. Just like it was for you when you were going for your promotion. Remember all that strife that you two went through?
Mm. It was awful.
You got through it then. You'll get through it now.
This time I'm not too sure.
Jay, quit your whine. Aotearoa, he would be crazy not to give Kahuko the contract.
Yeah, you'd think, eh?
Big celebration tonight, I reckon.
Yep, cross fingers.
Oh, and give me a text when you're here, okay?
Okay, will do.
Dylan Preston?
Dylan, hi, it's Jay. I just wanted to ring and apologise and say I'm so, so sorry about my friend's behaviour last night. I mean, she was drunk and she was way out of line. And I just want you to know that I really appreciate and respect everything that you have done for me. And I need our relationship to continue because...
Sorry, I'm busy. We'll talk later.
At least he didn't try and come over. That just makes it even weirder. You know, Alice thinks he's over-possessive.
She's a bit of an expert on dysfunctional boyfriends, apparently.
Yeah, especially mine. This is the second one she's tried to hit on.
She hit on Ant?
Yes.
I got the distinct impression she wasn't interested in that particular cut of meat.
Ask Ant.
Well, seems we have a lot to ask our friend.
He's had long enough to sweat. I need answers.
What possible excuse could there be for lying and stalking? My advice, you him, 10-foot barge pole.
Why do I always attract the screwed up ones?
In a word, naivety.
Thanks a lot.
It just makes you so easy to deceive and manipulate, sweetness. And then there's your penchant for the lost causes. Don't answer it. Tanya,
hi.
Tanya, I'm sorry. I understand why you're angry. I dealt with the situation yesterday badly.
Get to the point, Ant. What's going on?
Must have seemed so ridiculous, me driving off like that. Like some bad movie.
It wasn't funny. It was frightening.
That's the last thing I ever meant to do.
So why did you do it? Tell me.
I will, but not over the phone.
Fine. Look, I'm at work.
I just need a few days.
You know what? Forget it. I've had enough of these games.
It's not a game. If I could come over, I would. I miss you so much. But a few days and everything will be back to normal, trust me.
I can't trust you. You've blown that completely, Ant. We're finished.
No, we're not. We can get through this, I promise.
I don't want to. Goodbye, Ant.
Well done. Perfectly executed.